history. Everyone must stand alone. I hear you call my name, and it feels like home. When you call my name, it's like a little threat. Down on my knees, I wanna take you there. In the night hour, I can feel the power, just like a breath. You know I'll take you. Like an angel sighing, I have no choice. I hear your voice. Feels like flying out of the sky. Oh God, I think I'm falling out of the sky. I close my eyes. Heaven help me when you call my name. It's like a little prayer. Down on my knees, I wanna take you. Whisper softly to me, you're in control just like a child. Now I'm dancing, it's like a dream. No end and no beginning, you're here with me, it's like a dream. Let the choir sing. Just like a dream, you are what you see. Just like a print, no choice, your words can take me there. Like a prayer, I'll take you there. Like a dream to me. Like a prayer, I'll take you there. Like a dream to me. Like a prayer.
I have it on good authority that your band opened up for Toad the Wet Sprocket. Can you walk us through the experience?
I was in a band in the city for 5 or 6 years, and you know, like a lot of people. And we opened for some of the members of Toad the Wet Sprocket, who were doing kind of a post-Toad the Wet Sprocket tour. They were the only band with a name that we ever heard of that we played with or on the same stage as. Yeah, we were the first act on a 3-act bill. It was at Bottom of the Hill, and I believe it was, you know, probably a Monday night kind of terrible gig with maybe 10 people in the audience for them before it filled up for other people. But it was great. It was fun. All the kids learning music now, you don't realize how much you can do with it after, just to have fun with your friends as you get older. It was a blast.
We come from a time where you couldn't just buy one hit song. You had to determine if there are enough hits on a record before deciding to purchase it. With that in mind, which record, excluding greatest hits compilations, has the most bang for your buck hits on it?
What record has the most hit songs on it? Thriller, right? It's just Thriller. There's no other answer. I guess you could go Rumors. People always say the Eagles' greatest hits, but that's the greatest hits album. That's, you know, the Eagles. So, it's Thriller. It's just Thriller. There's no other answer to that question, right?
Right. That's correct. Especially when you look at radio hits. Although the rock person in me wants to say either Back in Black by AC/DC or my personal favorite, Appetite for Destruction by Guns N' Roses. So what type of band posters did you have on your wall growing up?
I had those. Those are my band posters from when I grew up. This one I got at my first concert in 1989. So what other ones did I have? I had a lot. I had Replacements and Cure. A lot of late 80s alternative kind of stuff. That's where I really got into music. I think Standing on the Beach by The Cure was the album that really kind of lit me up and showed me what music could be like that was different and not on the radio at the time. So I had a ton, and I worked at record stores, so you got all the best, you know, you got all the best record store posters, and you know, and they were free, so that was kind of awesome when you're a teenager.
If you had to pick one style of music that best defines you, what would it be and why?
Probably folk music, which is a weird thing to say, but then you can say folk music is all music, right? I just think it touched everything else and kind of wove its way into the rock music that I liked and grew up on. You know, the late John Prine and Lyle Lovett and all the Texas singer-songwriters, and then, you know, everybody that I grew up with playing with an acoustic guitar, you know, strumming along with, you know, these cheesed out, you know, maybe James Taylor songs or something. And so I think it's that. I mean, my greatest memories are listening to folk albums riding down the highway, right? Tom Waits' Closing Time, and Nancy Griffiths' Other Voices, Other Rooms, which was an album of folk covers, and, you know, listening to Gordon Lightfoot albums, and of course, Dylan and Prine. And so I think that's probably the music that's most connected to what I like, yeah. So, there you go.